Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to talk about how much money can you make on YouTube. Yes, how much money can you make on YouTube, and what's the process of making a withdrawal on YouTube. And if you've not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and hit like and comment and share. And today someone was asking me, how much can you make on YouTube in a month? Yes, that's a good question actually, but that depends on you. That's depends on a few factors that you should consider when thinking on how much can I make on YouTube in 1 month. And the first thing you should ask yourself is the content that I'm creating worth making money? That's the first thing, because YouTube pays you from the advertisers. The advertisers put the adverts on your video and then they pay you. But YouTube will put adverts that are worth your video. So there are videos that are not suitable for ads, and that means that you can make a video that has no ads in it, because they're not ads suitable, they don't have ad suitability. So the first thing you should consider is you should consider making videos that are ads suitable, that are most admired or favorable for advertisers, because for one, if you create a good video that has a different topic which is not best for the advertisers, there will be no adverts running on your video. And once more, the last time I spoke about making videos that are long. Yes, videos that are long tend to do well on YouTube, because if you make videos that are over 8 minutes, that means you'll be able to manage mid-roll ads. Yes, you can manage mid-roll ads, and that means that if you have a video that is over 8 minutes, you're going to go to the YouTube Creator Studio, then the specific video, then you go to the analytics, and then monetization, then you'll be able to manage the mid-roll section. Maybe you can put the advert at the first minute, third minute, 6 minute, or 8 minute, depends on the length of your video. And after that, maybe it would earn you a good amount of money when one watches your videos and maybe the adverts. And but it's not guaranteed that when you put a specific section of the ad, that those ads are going to be seen by everyone. YouTube tends to make them at least best for the viewers. So you might be using a one device here and another device here, and at the 6 minute there'll be an advert here, at the 6 minute there'll be no advert on the other device. Yeah, so you're supposed to know that and make sure that you're making long videos. And the first thing I said, that you're supposed to make a video that has good content for advertisers. Number three, what's your marketing strategy? Your marketing strategy is the key thing that is going to determine how much money you're going to get on YouTube in a month. One, there's a standard amount that you earn when you get 1,000 views. If you get 1,000 views, it depends on the location, on a few things. It depends on your location, where the viewers are coming from. One, if you are maybe, let's say, in a certain country like Tanzania, and you get 1,000 views, you can maybe get $1 or $2 for 1,000 views. And maybe someone else is in maybe England, UK, US, they'd be earning something like almost $700 for the 1,000 views and the like. So you're supposed to have a good marketing strategy, a strategy that is going to get people to watch your videos. If you want people to watch your videos, do a good research on marketing. And before, even before making the content, you're supposed to think, is this content that I'm making, is it worth, are people going to watch it, are people going to love it? Because as I said on the last video, is that you should make shareable videos, videos that people can watch, videos that people can share with their friends. So for one, I say that you should make videos that people are going to share, not only watching but also sharing. And also, if you create good videos with good content, people are going to, okay, actually the marketing thing will be easy because people will be looking for the keywords. And actually the other thing you should note in the marketing strategy, you should be using the right keywords that even people come to YouTube, they will search a certain keywords and they will be directed to your video, and your video will be the first on top to be seen when people do the search. So marketing strategy is what matters a lot, because if you have good numbers of people, you're going to make a good amount of money. So you're the one who is going to control the amount that you're going to earn on YouTube. The other thing that determines the amount of money you earn from YouTube is the way you package your content. Packaging your content matters a lot, because the way you give out the content, the way you have planned your content, is what you make viewers watch to the end. Because most of the people watch your content for just a few minutes, a few seconds, and then they're bored. Just try making the introduction, the first minute, to be the best part of that video. Because if you create a boring introduction, people are not going to leave your video like in the first few seconds. That means you're not going to make money. And then again, something that people maybe ignore or maybe they don't acknowledge, like getting subscribers is a good thing, because when you upload a new video, these subscribers will be notified. Let's say not all of them will watch the videos because they got a notification. Even some people will unsubscribe because the notification sometimes are so boring, are so irritating. And but a good amount of people will watch your video because they saw the notification. So you're supposed to think and to focus on creating a community, because if you create a bigger community of audience or subscribers on YouTube, they are going to be recurring, make a recurring community that supports you, that loves what you do, watches, and that comes from defining your target audience. That will determine who are watching. Am I targeting people who have this and this? Am I targeting people who have this and this? So you should create a community that supports you and always watches your stuff. So actually YouTube blocked the sub for sub thing because it was not helping, because someone subscribes on your account and then they don't watch anymore. So, and then one thing you should know, consistency is the key. If you have created your content and now you have a community, that's subscribers, now your main job is to keep them locked, is to keep them loving what you do. If you have made a decision to make a certain content, continue doing that content. Do not make your YouTube channel like a mixed up of content. Make a specific content for that YouTube channel. If you're creating comedy, just stick to comedy. If you're creating inspiration videos, just make inspiration videos. Because some people who love comedy might not love inspirations. Some people who love inspirations might not love the comedy thing. They might feel irritated that they fight comedy. They don't have that time. If you're doing preaching, please keep that channel for preaching, not for comedy. Today for comedy, tomorrow for preaching, the other day for I don't know what. So you should make your YouTube channel have one specific goal. When people come to your channel, they know what they want and they know what they are getting. So you should make that a priority, a number one goal, that you're creating a specific content. YouTube has an allowance. You can open another YouTube channel where you can create another channel for a different topic, a different content. So Another thing I was to talk about is for starters who are starting, how am I going to be paid on YouTube? Yes, we all know that for you to be monetized, you need 4,000 watch time hours and 1,000 subscribers. And once you're there, you'll be asked to open an AdSense account if you don't have any. But if you have any, you will link to the existing AdSense account. The AdSense account is where your money will reflect as you earn it. When does it reflect on your AdSense account, the money that you have earned on YouTube? The revenue that you have earned on YouTube will reflect on your account on from 9th to 14th of each and every month. So let's say it's on June, you're going to see your monthly earning on your AdSense on July from date 9 to 14th. So the money that you see on your AdSense is the amount that you are eligible for withdrawing. And there's a threshold for withdrawal, that is 70 euros or $100. So you are supposed to know if I get 69 euros or $900, you cannot withdraw the money you will withdraw from the next month. So one thing is that when you get to the threshold, that is over 70 euros or $100, you're going to see a payment button. Actually, it will be automatic on 26th, around there. And then if you have chosen the kind of withdrawal method that you choose, like maybe Western Union, maybe check, maybe bank or the like, you will see a section. For me, for the Western Union, you will see a MCN number, and then you will be able to collect your money, and boom, you have money. So guys, let's continue working hard. I'm struggling, and I'm also inspiring others to make more content, more engaging content that is going to earn you money. Because you cannot earn money if you're not creating good content, if you're not finding your audience, and it's up to you. The amount of money you make on a YouTube channel depends on you, depends on the things that I've talked about, and depends on yourself. How you are creating the content, how engaging the content is, and how much you're willing to you want to make. Because if you make $20 this month, maybe you can have a different target of making $50 or $100 the next month, because you will know this content did well than this, and this content did well than this. So guys, that's all I had for today, and I'm so humbled and I'm so grateful that you have watched this video till the end. And please subscribe to my channel and click the red button and share with your friends. Till next time, love you all.